Here's why the Miami Heat are scary again. After making the bubble finals in 2020, Butler, Bam Bam, and the Heatles experienced a massive setback in the next campaign, getting swept by their rivals from Milwaukee in the first round. But with Duncan Robinson heating up tremendously, the reigning champ who the Heat stole from the Bucks and PJ Tucker resembling his elite self when healthy, and the leadership of Kyle Lowry and Tyler Herro, who've stepped up in the absence of Butler and Adebayo, 2021-22's Heat team is on track for a bounce back year. So, can South Beach's basketball club get out of the Eastern Conference, and what are the other factors making Miami dangerous? Stay tuned to find out. Before continuing, only 11.5% of you watching right now are subscribed, so if you haven't already, please subscribe. Also, leave a thumbs up. It takes a few seconds and makes a massive difference. You can follow me on Instagram and Twitter at DFlowHoops, and I'll give you a follow back. Links in the description for both those platforms. While PJ Tucker's been out since December 19th with a lower body injury, his impact on the Heat's success has been extremely evident. Proving himself as one of the best wing defenders in all of basketball for the Bucks in last year's playoffs, Tucker locked down the opposing team's best perimeter threat in each of Milwaukee's four series wins. As I mentioned yesterday, the Bucks have made up for his absence with solid pickups, but no one is going to fully replace the combination of energy, versatility, IQ, strength, and lateral quickness brought to the table from PJ. Tucker went into Milwaukee looking to change their culture, and he ended up doing that so much that he helped turn the Bucks into champions. PJ currently ranks number 8 among all small forwards in defensive rating. But more surprisingly, a man at the same position as Tucker in Duncan Robinson ranks right behind PJ at number 9 among small forwards in defensive rating. You think of Robinson for his shooting, but he does have a 7'1" wingspan, which helps him contest shots and get out in the passing lanes. Having the toughness and all-around beastliness of Tucker, combined with the length and IQ of Robinson, makes for a special defensive tandem on the wing for Miami. The pickup of Tucker has made the Heat a much more intimidating unit overall, as now Jimmy Butler doesn't have to guard the opposing team's best player, he gets to defend opposing second options now. That not only makes the Heat tougher to score on, but it also saves Butler a ton of energy for his scoring. Duncan Robinson has gone through a well-documented shooting slump this season, as the four-year pro is posting the lowest three-point percentage since his rookie year at 33.9%. However, the undrafted product of Michigan has looked more like his sharpshooting self as of late, as Miami's wing is making a solid 38% of his deep-range bombs over the past 10 games. Everyone hating on Robinson after he secured a $98 million bag is forgetting one thing. The man shoots nearly 9 threes on average each night. That puts him as the number 11 ranked player in deep-range attempts, and among the leaders in 3-point chucks, Duncan's efficiency is 7th best. The man has a high arcing release that constantly draws ire for defensive game plans, as the threat of Robinson hitting distance daggers spaces out Miami's free-flowing offense. And when everyone's healthy, it's an offensive system that can really resemble Picasso painting a picture or Mozart composing a melody. Miami's system, orchestrated by Eric Spoelstra, has given them the 5th best offensive rating nearly midway through the season, and that's with their top two players in Jimmy Butler and Bam Adebayo both having missed 15 games each. Miami's dealt with a ton of injuries, which has led to two-way player Marcus Garrett stepping into the rotation for the past 5 games, and prior to this stretch, Garrett was either with the Sioux Falls Skyforce or at the end of the bench. The players currently sidelined include Jimmy Butler, Bam Adebayo, Victor Oladipo, Markieff Morris, and Caleb Martin. I believe it was just reported that Caleb Martin and Markieff Morris are being activated off protocols right now. But unfortunately for Heat fans, 2 more rotation players sustained injuries in the team's last 2 games against Detroit, as PJ Tucker and Dwayne Dedmon have been placed on reserve. The good news is Dedmon is only expected to miss 1 to 2 weeks after an MRI revealed a grade 1 plus MCL sprain on his left knee. And while Eric Spoelstra didn't offer a timetable for the return of PJ Tucker, who's dealing with a leg injury, Spo did say, quote, "He's feeling better, we'll continue to evaluate him every day." Both Spoelstra and Heat fans are probably desperate to get PJ back into the lineup, considering the man is making an elite 45.5% of his 3-point shots over 33 games. That deep range mark is a career high by far, as before taking his talents to South Beach, Tucker hadn't even shot 40% throughout a season. If anything, this setback will keep the lockdown 36-year-old fresh for the playoffs, and with a player with over 1,000 pro games between the pros and overseas under his belt, you want to be extremely cautious with any injury. We still have to see the form that Butler and Adebayo are in to legitimately declare this 21-22 Heat squad as top contenders, but every other factor aside from that points to that being the case. In the absence of the two faces of the franchise, Kyle Lowry deserves some respect for stepping up as the number one guy, like he did for so many years with my Raptors. The month of December has seen the six-time All-Star and NBA champion average an extremely consistent 16 points, 9 assists, 4 rebounds on 44% shooting from the field and 35% from three-point range. Incredibly, the now 35-year-old is still laying his body on the line like a guy in his mid-20s, as Kyle currently leads the NBA in charges drawn, and among the leaders in that area, he's the oldest player ahead of Blake Griffin by over 3 years. Lowry's already drawn 21 charges, and he drew 20 the entirety of last season. But it's not like that's a shocker for anyone, because in addition to being an elite playmaker, Lowry's hustle has always been one of the most valuable features in his bag. Kyle's been tops in charges for the last 5+ years. While the Heat's point guard last year and Goran Dragic led the Heat in scoring during 2021's playoffs, that was completely because the rest of Miami's roster was gassed from the bubble. Dragic had his moments in a Heat uniform, but by the end of his tenure, he was severely lacking defensively. Lowry's given the Heat an absolutely massive upgrade at the most important position in the modern NBA, so this 21-22 Heat team is a lot more scary for that fact alone. But now for one of the headlining segments of this video, a breakdown of the breakout sharpshooting two guard, Tyler Herro. Herro's plus one ahead of Kyle Lowry, making his plus minus a plus 64, which is currently good enough for the highest among all of the Heat's top players. He's able to slice through defenses in the pick and roll, given the threat he is to simply execute a few dribble combinations, stop on a dime, and pull up from three-point range. That marksman-esque three-point shooting opens up seams in the defense for Herro to get what he wants off the dribble. The development of Herro in merely his third season as a pro basketball player is game-changing for Miami, because just think back to the 2020 finals, when Herro was just an unpolished rookie. On the perimeter, Butler had to create every bit of offense for the Heat. Of course, Adebayo's playmaking and post-scoring from 15 feet in definitely helped. However, Butler needed help to manufacture offense off the dribble beyond the top of the key, as the Lakers often trapped Jimmy and got away with it. So, therefore, Herro's progression is the biggest reason I think the Heat are an overwhelming opponent to take down 4 times out of 7 again, unlike they were in 2021, and like they were back in the bubble. Now for Community Speaks. With the results after the last shoutout of the holiday season, and with the honorable mentions, the top 3 commenters earning NBA gear of their choosing are Ona Ebodaga, Boston Haltane, and The Flesh. Each of you win an NBA jersey, shoe, or equipment of your choosing. Leave your handle in the comments or message me on Instagram or Twitter at DFlowHoops for the details. For everyone on the Speaks board, whether you received a prize or not, thank you for always leaving your take. Even if you didn't get on the board, thank you for leaving your take. And I have good news for all of you competitive commenters. The Speaks board now resets with the next giveaway happening over the summer. And this time I'm choosing 5, potentially up to 7 winners, so there'll be plenty of more opportunities to win. But regardless of if you win or not, you guys make the Speaks competition extremely heated in the comments section. So for all of you up on the board in each of my videos, you guys should take a ton of pride in being the best Hoops Talk community on YouTube. Again, for the winners, leave your handle in the comment section so I know it's you. DFlow signing off.